lots of front row seats if anybody wants to. Closer. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
As Pastor Jason would say to you, you are miracles of God's grace and mercy. And we welcome you here this morning for our Hymn Sing Sunday and our first Sunday back out here in the park. I hope you're excited to be here. I think it's a beautiful place to worship. I mean, what better setting could we have to worship the God who created all of this beauty that surrounds us? This morning, I will be leading you in worship, and I'll try to do my best. Usually, I'm leading you just singing and playing the piano, but I have other duties this morning, so I'll do the best I can. I can kind of see everybody. I can see everybody over here. I'll wave this way. Matt says I have a pole right here blocking me, and I can't do anything about that because the pavilion would fall down on our heads if we moved that. I guess I could have moved myself. This morning, for announcements, I just wanted to say that next Sunday, if you have not, is there anybody that has not received one of those little slips, those little, they're not really refrigerator magnets, but they're little slips to hang on your refrigerator that tells you for the month of June whether we're going to be in the church or in the park? Is there anybody that hasn't gotten one of those? Because if you have not, we have extra copies of that in the little box where you picked up your bulletin. So if you haven't gotten one of those, Pastor Jason put that together, and there's a little picture of the church, and there's a little picture of the park, so you'll know which place you're supposed to be which week. But next week is June the 20th, and that is a special day. I think it's a special day for all the men that we have here and the men of our church. It's Father's Day, and we will be celebrating that at the church. But you have one assignment for Father's Day, and I don't know if you've read your newsletter, but you are to come dressed in your best tropical-looking attire. So get out those Hawaiian shirts that you don't get to wear very often, especially you men. And ladies, you can wear your flowery things next Sunday, and let's make it look real, real festive and nice and tropical. I know that we are going to be giving a nice tropical treat after church, and I think there's something special for the men folk as well. So that's next Sunday. Wear your tropical attire, your Hawaiian shirts, whatever you happen to have. And also, I'd like to give a reminder that we have Vacation Bible School that is going to be coming up, and I know that there is still need for people to be volunteers to help out with that. So if you are interested in being a volunteer, make sure you get with the right people to let them know that you are really interested in helping out with the kids, because this is a wonderful opportunity. I'm just amazed to see you all sitting here this morning. I have to tell you that, with no masks on, and here we are just celebrating the glory of the Father with everything kind of being, can I say the word, over as much as possible, that we're all here able to do this. Last year, we were here kind of out of necessity. This year, we're here because we want to be. So I think that's a wonderful thing, and I think that we should be thankful for that. But Vacation Bible School volunteers are needed. I know they're collecting boxes, cardboard boxes for that, for the decorations that they're going to be doing. So if you have extra cardboard boxes, please drop those off at the church so that they can create the things that they need to create. If you haven't picked up a hymnal, I'll be honest, I'll confess this morning that I decided there were a lot of lyrics to type, so it was just as easy to grab some hymnals and toss them in a box and bring them for you. And that way you've got the notes, and you've got the harmonies, and you can sing the melody, or you can choose to sing the harmony, and we can make some beautiful music together this morning. So you have your hymnals to follow along. And I think that's about all the announcements that I have this morning. Let me check my notes so that I make sure I say everything. In case you don't know where Pastor Jason is, he didn't skip town. Well, he did. He skipped town with his family. He's on a vacation. They're having a wonderful time down in Gatlinburg. They love to go there, and that's where Pastor is this morning. I do want to say hello to our friends who are joining us on Facebook. I'm guessing that there are a few more people perhaps this morning joining us on Facebook and going to church from their homes, because I understand there's a pretty important baseball game that's going to be played this morning. So I'm grateful for all of you because I wasn't sure how many people were going to be here this morning, because I agree it's an important baseball game, and we'll be praying for them a little bit later that things are very successful and everybody has a wonderful experience doing that. Your offering plate is up here, and after the service, if you would like to come up when Mark is playing his final number for us, Mark Nightingale, who's here to play his beautiful trombone this morning. If you want to come up and put your offering in there, just make sure the Bible is in there, not only to have the Word of God present, but also it's helping us to hold down any envelopes that you put into the offering plate so that those don't blow away. So make sure you slip it underneath the Bible when you do that. That's all of my announcements, and I'm going to ask Bev to come up and lead us in our focus this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I echo Susie's sentiments about seeing everybody out there. It's great to be here. Looking forward to the service. Music and song express our faith in a living and active way. Music is by nature full of movement and energy. When we express our faith in song, we experience the living, active nature of faith. Music is robust and lively. Even slow and ponderous songs have forward movement and involve energy in their execution. Music proceeds from life and it feeds life. Only living things can make music. Humans and birds, for example. You can hear it.
There they are.
Even instruments must be played with the breath or the action of the living thing. At the same time, music feeds life. It injects joy and energy into the people, creating it or listening to it. It makes us lift our voices, clap our hands, and tap our feet. We are here today to express our faith in song, and we hope that the Holy Spirit will inspire you to clap your hands, tap your feet as you joyfully sing and thank God for the gift of music. Please focus your hearts and minds this morning as you listen to these words from Psalm 104, verse 33. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. Let us pray. O Lord, please bless our musical offerings this morning that they might glorify your name. May the talents that you have bestowed upon us be used always to serve you. Let our worship and song be a witness to your majesty and love, and remind us that you are always watching and listening from your throne above. May your presence and beauty be found in every note, and may the words that are sung reach deep into the hearts of everyone who is here this morning, so they will draw closer to you. May the Holy Spirit guide us through every measure so that we might be the instruments of your peace and proclaim your glory with glad voices and hearts filled with joy. In thy name we pray. Amen. You may remain seated for the opening songs of praise, but, as John Wesley has instructed us, make sure that you sing spiritually and have an eye to God in every word that you sing. Take it away.
By the way, I'd like to thank my helpers this morning who are helping me to song lead. I think you'll recognize these two.
Thank you.
into a time of prayer now, but if you'll notice in your bulletins this morning, our prayer song is going to be us lifting our voices through a song. And as we do that, I would like you to focus on just a few things. And if there's anything that you would like to add, I don't have a microphone to take out to you, but if there's something that you want to speak loudly and share with everyone as a joy or a concern, I'll open that up to anybody that has anything this morning that's on your hearts, on your minds. Anyone? I'd like to pray this morning for anyone who's vacationing or traveling, particularly our beloved Sharp family who is traveling, and I know that they're having a wonderful time, but we always pray for safety when Pastor Jason and Emily and the kids are traveling and on the road. And I want to ask us to also be thinking and be very mindful in the days ahead of praying for our Vacation Bible School, because it is such an important thing that we're hosting this year. And we need to not only pray for the people that are going to be the staff and the teachers and the helpers and the volunteers, but I think we also need to pray for the kids. We need to pray that their hearts are open and their minds are open and that they're receptive to all of the things that they're going to be learning, and that they're there with a heart of Jesus and to connect and to build that relationship. So pray for the kids too. I'd like you to pray for this summer. I know that Pastor, if you've read your newsletter, put out kind of a request and asking for some volunteers to step up and perhaps organize some fun summer activities. I read the list and said, wow, this looks like a lot of fun. But I think that we need to have some people that are willing to maybe take one of those on and you know, create something wonderful for our church family, to be able to go to a Mud Hens game or the zoo or some of those things that he had listed. So think about that and pray for the right people to lead those activities this summer. We need to pray for Coach Selgo. And I understand that Assistant Coach Versham, and we also have Wayne Newman is a grandpa with a grandson, I believe, on the team. And we need to make sure that we are praying for a wonderful blessing from God this morning, that everyone plays safely and with good sportsmanship, and we're just going to lift those young men up and their coaches and the staff so that they can have a wonderful, wonderful outcome to this morning's game. It's a big deal. It's important. Kids work hard to get to this point, and I can vouch for that, because I'm around kids all the time, and they do. They work hard. They put their heart and soul into it. So we lift them in prayer this morning. We need to be prayerful for the future of our church. I think God is in the process right now of rolling out some great things to us, and I think that we need to be prayerful for those plans as he reveals them, and we need to be willing to do whatever it takes and work towards the goals that he's laying out in front of us. So we're going to be lifting all of those things, not only this morning as we sing Kumbaya, which means come by here. We're asking the Holy Spirit to be here and join us right now as we prayerfully sing together. We're going to follow this song, and you're going to help me out this morning, by singing the Lord's Prayer today. So I think you've heard it before. We're going to do a familiar version. You've probably maybe heard it at a wedding or a different activity. So we're going to lift our voice in song, and we're going to sing the Lord's Prayer this morning. Let's sing Kumbaya, come by here.
Bye.
come up and read our scripture for us this morning.
The first scripture reading is taken from Psalm 33, verses 1 to 9. Let the godly sing for joy to the Lord. It is fitting for the pure to praise him. Praise the Lord with melodies on the lyre. Make music for him on the ten-stringed harp. Sing a new song of praise for him. Play skillfully on the harp and sing with joy. For the word of the Lord holds true, and we can trust everything he does. He loves whatever is just and good. The unfailing love of the Lord fills the earth. The Lord merely spoke, and the heavens were created. He breathed the word, and all the stars were born. He assigned the sea its boundaries and locked the oceans in vast reservoirs. Let the whole world fear the Lord, and let everyone stand in awe of him. For when he spoke, the world began.
Thank you. Now just kind of relax, and I'm going to ask Mark to share some of his favorites. I think there'll be some of your favorites too. Mark has been at our church and played on a couple different occasions, and I know it's always a real treat and a real blessing. He comes to us from a long ways away, up the road in Stryker, and we're very blessed that he could be here on our Music Sunday this morning. So we welcome Mark this morning.
Thank you.
While the CD is deciding to play, I'll tell you that Mark shared this morning that he's had this instrument since 1975. It's his favorite. He prefers this one over the newer ones that he has because it just has a beautiful tone. But I think partly that's the player too, don't you?
Yeah.
Probably built better too.
Thank you.
do our benediction and our benediction response that you don't go anywhere too fast, because I know that he has a little encore prepared for us today and you're really going to like it. So make sure that you stick around. Our next song, our songs of adoration this morning, you can find on page 369. Let's all sing Blessed Assurance together. 369. To come up, and the children, come on up. Any of our children, please come on up with Jim. He's going to give you a little children's message today. Come on up, guys. Anybody else that wants to join them, the young at heart can also come on up. This is a message for all of us. Hi, guys. Come on. You want to come over here? Or right up here?
Yourself more comfortable. Sit down. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Is it wet there?
Is it wet?
Maybe we should have those rugs.
I know.
Oh, well.
Matt's laughing. I'll tell you why later.
Nobody knows. Really.
I wanted to bring the rugs, but I got the rugs.
Okay. Oh, wonderful. Today, Oh, I'm talking to a lot of children here. I have two of the biggest children right here, and we're going to have such a wonderful time talking about the scripture today comes from Hebrews. Probably won't be following that much, but Hebrews. Hebrews is a wonderful book. It's all through it. It talks about salvation. And salvation is very important. Salvation is the most wonderful. You know, the more we talk about our salvation, the more we enter into the rest of our salvation, the rest of God. We enter and become more comfortable in that we are saved, and it's peaceful. It's joyful. It's so wonderful. You know, Hebrews also in chapter 12 is talking about discipline. Have you ever heard that word? No, you've never heard the word discipline. Oh, well, that's a good thing. And I'm going to tell you about discipline today. My mother was a big discipline for me, and I learned discipline in the way of doing my chores every day. And she wanted me to learn how to play the piano, believe it or not. Well, you don't know me. But anyway, I was just a young person, and John Thompson's Modern Course for the Piano. Anybody ever seen this?
Yeah.
You know, I can still play Runaway River and Traffic Cop. You know? No, that's not it. Da 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 river, you know. Anyway, it's probably the only two songs I can play. But my wife, and she was a wonderful, wonderful inspiration in my life. She started out being disciplined, and it takes discipline to play the piano. Yeah, at 5 years old, she started to learn how to play the piano. She learned so well that she taught music for 39 years. Wonderful, wonderful inspiration, not only to her family, but to the whole Defiance central local school system. You know, everybody around, it was so wonderful for so long. Discipline is something we need to do. You know, I didn't have a whole lot of discipline. When I sat down, it was 30 minutes a day. And that was the longest time on that piano bench. You know, I actually hurt from sitting there, and it was only a half hour, and I'm just a little boy, but, you know, I didn't have much discipline. But if you want to do something in life, you need to learn discipline. And that's what the Lord was talking about. Well, that's what the author of Hebrews was talking about. You know, the author of Hebrews is a wonderful book. He was such an eloquent writer. And he was very versed in the scriptures. Does anybody know? You know, I'm still wondering who the author of Hebrews was. I don't know. Is anybody out there can tell me? The author of Hebrews, anybody? No, I don't know either. See, but anyway, he was a very eloquent man, and he was associated with Paul, probably pretty close, but we don't know whether it was a he or a she. It might have been a Priscilla. But they never signed the book of Hebrews, so nobody knows. Yeah, the church fathers, they wanted so much for the book of Hebrews to be into the canonization of the Bible, and because they love the book of Hebrews. You know why? Because all through the book of Hebrews, it talks about salvation, and that's very important to us. But they had to wait a while because the author didn't sign it, and they didn't exactly know who wrote Hebrews. But anyway, so much for that. It's discipline, and you know, the Lord talks about discipline in, the author of Hebrews speaks about discipline all through there too, but then he speaks about discipline in that the children, the ancestors of these Hebrews that wandered in the wilderness for 40 years, God led them in the wilderness for 40 years. And you know, these people, the Israelites, they tested and they tried God's patience for 40 years. You know why? Because they weren't very obedient, and they were led around. And although for 40 years God he had miracles. Miracles all the time. He fed them. He led them. And he parted the waters. You know, it seems like they could have been a little bit more obedient, but they weren't. But anyway, that's what we must learn, is obedience to God today. I got a song to sing to you. This is I heard we were singing hymns today. I gotta take a ukulele. Would you like to hear me play the ukulele and sing? Okay, well, I'll sing a song for you. Where is my ukulele? Oh, I shouldn't be so organized. Okay. I wonder maybe if you could even hear my ukulele too if I kind of put this down. But what I do need, because I wasn't disciplined enough. I changed the words in this song, you see. But then I didn't memorize the words. I just changed them. And so, you know, I change the words in this song quite often, so it's kind of hard to memorize something when it changes. You know what this is? Do you know what kind of instrument this is? It's a ukulele. And for short, it's uke. You know, when kids play this, and my daughter, she plays the ukulele, and she said, Dad, can you make a ukulele rack for me? And I says, oh, yeah, I'm a woodworker. You know, I like to work in wood, carve and that. And so I says, I'll make a ukulele rack for you. How many ukuleles you got? She said, 27.
She uses them in her classroom. They all learn ukulele.
So she's a kindergarten, K through 5 teacher in Sylvania, Maplewood Schools, and she has this ukulele rack in her room that's 10 feet long and two racks of ukuleles, 27 of them all together. Can you hear this? A little song somebody wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when we worry, we make it double. Don't worry. Be happy. Say we trust in Jesus all of our life, but when troubles come, suddenly we're feeling some strife. But don't worry, be happy, and Jesus will lead us all of the way if we put our trust in Him today. And don't worry, be happy. Don't worry. Don't worry. Be happy. He raised the dead, made a lame man walk, the blind to see and the dumb to talk. Don't worry. Be happy. Him lead us every day. Stick close to Him, trust and pray, and don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Don't worry. Be happy. Yeah. And let's sing a new song unto the Lord. Hey, let's all sing in one accord. Don't worry. Be happy. Yeah, sing this new song along with me. We will claim our victory. Yeah, don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry. Come on now. Come on. Don't worry. Come on. Be happy. Do you like this song? I do too. Wonderful.
involvement.
Let's have a little prayer and then you guys can go back, okay? Lord, we pray. We pray to you today, Lord. It's the most important thing, Lord. We're asking you just to help us to have discipline as we grow. We know our parents love us so much, and that's why they discipline us. So, Father, help our parents, too, to be guided by you. In Jesus' name, and help us to grow up big and strong and play the piano or whatever, but be disciplined. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jim.
To share a scripture this morning with you that this week when our conference was meeting virtually, not at the beautiful lakeside this time, but virtually for conference, this was a main theme of theirs, to run the race with perseverance. And the scripture taken from Hebrews was the scripture that I think they were focusing on this week.
All right. Scripture from Hebrews, as Jim so eloquently told us about. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and protector of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God.
And now our good friend Skip is going to come up, and he's going to share some of what was discussed and just a little bit of an update on what happened with annual conference. Thank you, Skip.
Thank you, Susie. And thank you for letting me represent this congregation for now the third year at annual conference. Pastor Jason and I sat in front of our computers for a couple of days, taking it all in. And I'd like to give you a little report on that. Began last Sunday around 2 o'clock, and first sessions lasted, I think, 5 hours, and then on Monday we had another, like, 7 hours in front of our laptops and absorbing everything. The conference was presided over by Bishop Gregory Palmer, and did a fine job. And give you some of the first things on tap were appointments. And I think Pastor Jason will be with us another year. That's a good thing. And then we got down to the nitty-gritty, the business of the conference. This is called the Book of Reports, and most of the rest of the conference was involving this. And I will give you this to look at if you care to question anything I say today. So, but we began with that, and there were 10 reports, mostly financial for the conference. And then there were recommendations on voting, and there were delegates like me there and pastors, well over 1,000 people voting on these things. And for the most part, everything passed at better than a 90% majority. So seemed to be in good order as the conference goes. Our conference did have some difficult times. This was the year of COVID, you know. There's never been a conference quite like that following a pandemic that's, you know, worldwide like that. So, you know, as individuals, we had challenges. As congregations, we had challenges. You know, as a conference, there were challenges. And but United Methodists seemed to find a way. Faith in Christ, as the bishop said, and we can do anything. You know, when COVID first hit, congregations were struggling, pastors were struggling, and it took a while to find our stride, so to speak. This church had a hybrid type sermon with our outdoor sermons and church indoor things. Some churches went to total online services. Some churches met in the parking lot. It was like a drive-in movie. Sat in your car, you got the message, loudspeaker, bullhorn, whatever it takes, responding, amens and hallelujahs, no, a chorus of horns, you know. You just got to get resourceful, and that's what a pandemic can do for you as an individual, as a congregation, as a conference. Different churches found different ways, and throughout the entire conference, we have little breaks here, and individuals like high school seniors would talk about how they got through a year when they were much anticipation, couldn't get their diploma and a regular commencement, couldn't go to prom, couldn't have a high school musical, you know, and how they got through it. And that first time when you're going off to college, what that was like as well, you know. And then there was, you know, as people got through this, the United Methodist Church just continued to do what they do. When COVID first hit, apportionments for like 3 months in a row were down 20% to the annual conference. But Methodists being Methodists, by the end of the year, they were down only 3% total towards the 2020 budget. Incredible. But that's who we are. Also, there were some incredible needs out there. You know, the best one I heard all conference was a heartfelt thank you from a lady from the North Katanga Project, which we've supported. Many of our churches in the Western Ohio Conference support. Her simple wish was, all they wanted was soap, and face masks. Well, they got real resourceful. They got their soap, and they learned how to weave face masks from the leaves from a banana plant. Now, they didn't have any pictures of this, but can you imagine? But these are the things the congregations did just so they could go to church. Wings in the morning flew every day, bringing medical attention to people all through COVID, all through the civil wars of the Republic of Congo. But here we are, sitting out in our lawn chairs, enjoying a pleasant Sunday morning, And those are the things they had to do to go to church. So I just wanted you to be aware of that, looking forward to the challenges of next year. While COVID was going on this past year, you all know UMCOR, our disaster relief organization. UMCOR responded to 3 hurricanes and a series of tornadoes around the Dayton area. Just like anything else was going on in the world, like a pandemic, UMCOR went out and did that. So these are just the things you're a part of, and just wanted you to know that. Look forward to representing you next year at the conference, if you'll let me. And
it's virtual. I'm sure they won't mind at all.
That's the good news, Susie. It will be back at Lakeside June 2nd to the 5th. Okay. Thank you for listening, and thank you for letting me represent you. And anyone that wants this book, you can look it.
Thank you, Skip. Thank you. For our closing song, it's up to you, but if you'd like to stand, we will stand. And you know, Bev gave us some instructions at the beginning that we were to sing spiritually and with an eye to God. And let's just really lift our voices to the heavens as we sing 370, Victory in Jesus.
Like me.
want to thank everyone who participated in our worship service, especially Mark this morning. We're so grateful to have you here this morning with us. And hope that you'll come back many times to play, because it's always such a treat. We are going to close this morning with the prayer that we've been praying for quite a long time now. And I think it's printed. I had it printed in your bulletin. Let's pray together our prayer. Jesus, here we go. Jesus, as you said we would do greater things, we pray that we might be strengthened by your Spirit to do something so big that if you're not in it, we fail. Go ahead and have a seat. We're going to close out with this one that I picked for our benediction response. It might be a little unfamiliar, but I think you'll catch on quickly. It's an old-time spiritual, and it goes along with that Hebrew scripture that we are running the race, and we have to do it with perseverance. Guide my feet. Wonderful, wonderful Sunday and a better week this week. Ha 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 ha